Eric, why are you putting your 40 cal suit on?
The customer wants to see me rack out that medium voltage breaker, and it's got a 30 cal arc flash label on it.
Well, why don't you show them the other options for racking that breaker out?
I guess I should. I could show them the integral racking or the remote power racking device.
Actually, I was thinking we could show them this Power Expert dashboard and we could rack it out from here.
That's a great idea. But since I am half dressed and I love wearing this suit, I'm thinking maybe we could just go ahead and show the customer what their people have to do so they can really see the benefits of the different arc flash solutions.
That sounds like a great plan. In our arc flash video, we discuss how arc flash has become one of the most important safety considerations for anyone working on or around electrical equipment. In addition, we highlighted a few examples of arc flash solutions. Eaton has more than 100 solutions for arc flash. Time and distance are typically the variables that we focus on to eliminate or reduce the risk of arc flash injuries or equipment damage. But every system and situation is unique and may require some additional considerations. Of course, de-energizing your equipment is always the safest bet, but we know that isn't always possible. In this video, we will highlight some key arc flash reduction or elimination techniques and help you decide which solutions might be right for your power system. There are essentially two main categories of arc flash solutions. One, solutions that protect people and equipment by reducing the arc flash energy. And two, solutions that put people out of harm's way in case an arc flash occurs. In either case, the first step in understanding the arc flash energy levels and the requirements for personal protective equipment, or PPE, is analysis of the power system. Our services team has done thousands of arc flash studies and can help you determine what you are up against when designing solutions appropriate for your system.
So, let's start by talking about solutions that reduce the arc flash energy to protect people and equipment. Here are five of our favorite examples of arc flash energy reduction techniques that you could consider for your system. Arc quenching switchgear is revolutionizing the industry by creating a solution that not only protects your gear, but anyone standing near your switchgear during an arc flash event. Basically, arc quenching switchgear uses a system of light sensors, current sensors, and this device to create a parallel arc during an uncontrolled arc in the switchgear to provide an alternate and controlled path for fault current until an upstream device can clear the fault. During this scenario, your people and equipment are protected because the arc quenching switchgear reacts so fast and responds before the dangerous pressure wave builds up. With this demonstration, we can show you exactly how arc quenching switchgear works. Eaton's Arc Flash Reduction Maintenance System, or ARMS, is available on low voltage power circuit breakers and many of our molded case circuit breakers. This system uses patented technology to reduce fault clearing time, lowering the available arc flash energy at the connected downstream equipment like motor control centers, switchboards, panel boards, or other equipment. The system may be activated at the breaker or from a remote location. The result is a reduction of the incident energy during equipment maintenance, allowing for improved personnel safety while eliminating the need for higher levels of costly personal protective equipment, or PPE. With a lock applied at the breaker during your lockout tagout procedure, you can ensure that you are protected while working on downstream equipment. A variation of the ARM system for utility power systems or for large industrials that use vacuum reclosers like this one is the hotline tag, which essentially will lock the recloser, tripping as fast electrically as the device can mechanically, and locking out after one event. This can significantly reduce arc flash energy for medium voltage systems. For most power systems, the highest level of arc flash energy on low voltage switchgear is on the source or line side of the main circuit breaker. One great option we can show you here at the PSEC is the arc flash limiter or AFL conversion. For this demonstration, we have replaced the typical medium voltage primary fuses protecting this transformer with a medium voltage vacuum circuit breaker, and we installed current transformers, or CTs, on the secondary of the transformer and added another protective relay. Since the breaker has two protective devices that can trip it, one is set as it normally would to overcome the 12 times inrush current for the transformer, and the other is connected to the transformer's secondary CTs. Using an arm setting on the medium voltage breaker, it will trip without delay during a fault condition. This arc flash label indicates that the arc flash energy at the line side of the breaker is normally 68 calories. The AFL solution significantly reduces the arc flash energy to 1.4 calories during maintenance conditions. Through high-speed communication, zone selective interlocking, or ZSI, deactivates the preset delays or coordination settings on the circuit breaker closest to the fault, which then trips with no intentional delay. This reduces the amount of time current flows and the amount of arc flash energy and stress the system encounters during fault conditions. This results in improved personal protection and prolonged equipment life. Typically, when a fault occurs on a solidly grounded power system, tens of thousands of amps of fault current flow to the fault. A high resistance grounding, or HRG system, limits the magnitude of current during a phase to ground fault to less than 5 amps. This reduces arc flash energy, increasing personnel and equipment protection. Operators are alerted to faulted conditions and can easily locate the ground source via built-in fault tracing. High resistance grounding is typically used on industrial power systems that have many large motors, and more recently is used on data centers where large three-phase UPSs are the major loads. These systems allow for a free ground fault with no release of arc flash energy.
Now, switching gears a little bit, let's talk about arc flash solutions that keep people out of harm's way. The first solution is called arc resistant switchgear and MCCs. In general, arc resistant equipment contains and redirects arc energy away from personnel and the facility out of the top of the equipment. The most common is called type 2B, meaning you can walk all the way around a section of equipment, and if an arc flash occurred inside, you wouldn't be hurt because the arc flash energy would be exhausted or dissipated out of the top, and in some cases through a plenum outside the room or area where you are working. Here is an example of our 15 kV class medium voltage switchgear. And here is our new XGIS 38 kV switchgear. Notice the heavy duty construction and additional doors on the relay sections to protect you while working on the control equipment and relays. The next solution focuses on remote operation and racking of circuit breakers. This includes integrated racking that can be remotely operated with a pendant, like this one, or through an HMI. It also includes the MRR1000 and RPR2 racking devices that can be installed and then controlled from a safe distance away, as shown here. Finally, for motor control centers with FlashGuard MCC can be withdrawn and installed with the door closed and has this rototrack remote operator to keep personnel out of harm's way in the event of an arc flash. More and more, we are asked by our customers to provide equipment that can be remotely operated or controlled with an HMI to reduce exposure during arc flash events. This Power Expert dashboard is a perfect solution to not only see what the arc flash levels are, but you can monitor power flow and control the equipment. Here at the PSEC, we can demonstrate remote racking on the medium voltage breakers, operate the main time main on our low voltage switchgear, as well as turn on the arms settings for any breakers with the dashboard. The dashboard is also a convenient place to store all of your one-line diagrams, riser diagrams, and maintenance records for your equipment. This helps you quickly find information and solve problems.
Although there are many other solutions for arc flash safety, here are a few more that we typically highlight for our visitors here at the PSEC, like these IR windows that allow you to look for potential issues inside your switchgear, switchboards, or other equipment like busway. This double door safety switch allows you to install fuses and make connections on the load side of this switch without being exposed to the line side or energized connections. This greatly reduces the risk, as you must consider the arc flash level of the source side even if the switch is in the open position with the door open on a standard switch. Anything that compartmentalizes electrical components generally helps with arc flash. This line isolation switch creates an external connection point for enclosed control cabinets, allowing you to lock out this switch and completely isolate the inside of the control cabinet. In most applications, the incoming breaker or connection point inside of one of these control cabinets has line voltage and again must be considered as live for arc flash considerations. InstallGuard provides continuous, non-invasive online monitoring of medium voltage generators, motors, switchgear, unit substation dry-type transformers, bus duct, and cable connections. The benefit is that you can prevent flashovers of insulation and potential arc flash conditions. With very inexpensive monitoring, you can get notifications before something happens and you can take steps to fix potential issues. For liquid-filled transformers, you might want to consider a vacuum fault interrupter or VFI option like this one, which allows you to have the primary protection device, a vacuum breaker, installed in the tank along with the visible means of disconnect. In addition, you can also put the oil sample valve on the side like this transformer instead of behind the door. This allows you to do oil testing without opening the transformer doors on a pad-mounted transformer like this one.
As you can see, there are many solutions for arc flash. This video highlights some of the key solutions that you might want to consider, but we can help you decide which are right for you.
Eaton has recently created a website that can help you evaluate the need for arc flash solutions and show you options that are available to protect your people and equipment. Check out the website to learn more.
If you want to learn more about these arc flash solutions and any other options that are available, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today.